Good evening, everyone. I'm meteorologist Ryan Argenti. Now, we didn't have a 6 o'clock newscast for this evening, but I wanted to at least get the latest weather information out to you from the Weather Center. Taking a live look over our Storm Team Live Radar Network, you can see widespread showers across our area now. Franklin and Adams County were just dealing with some moderate showers, but since then, we've seen that moderate rain push from west to east over York and Lancaster counties, and a little spot over up towards Harrisburg and Hershey as well, dealing with some showers there. And even parts of our northwestern counties, up towards Mifflin, Juniata, and Perry counties, we are expecting to see some more moderate showers impact that area. So very beneficial rain so far across the valley. 55 degrees is our high for the day today. We're right around par for this time of year. 56 degrees are our average highs this time of year. And we'll continue to deal with more of this rain, more widespread light to moderate rain. It'll stay seasonable into the lower 50s. We'll have a light 5 to 10 mile an hour breeze. As we go into tonight, it'll be 48 to 52 degrees, excuse me. Those showers will taper closer towards the morning hours, but again, it'll be breezy, it'll be mild, 5 to 15 miles an hour from the south. For tomorrow afternoon, 64 to 68 degrees. We'll start with some clouds earlier in the day, and then we're going to transition to more mostly sunny conditions. It'll stay mild and breezy as well. We'll have a westerly 10 to 15 mile an hour breeze, 64 to 68 degrees. 51 now in Carlisle, 50 in Lebanon, 51 in Lancaster at this hour, and the next precipitation chance that we have is going to be on Thursday, and I'm expecting to have a similar impact like we are dealing with now in terms of rain chances. But again, we are still very dry across the valley, and certainly the widespread showers that we're dealing with now should put a slight dent into the drought that we're dealing with for the majority of the valley. But again, here are those widespread showers that are now affecting the area and really affecting the majority of the Commonwealth at this hour. As we look at our predictor, we can see those showers are going to be lasting through the rest of the night. Now, as we get into Monday morning, that cold front hasn't pushed through yet, but it will be passing through by the time we get into the Monday morning commute. And as soon as that cold front passes through, we'll clear up with some high pressure building in just a little bit. We do have a front that's off to our northwest, although it's a very dry cold front, and that's not going to be associated with any impactful rain or any showers. But with some of these frontal boundaries that are pushing through, it will impact our cloud cover, and I could see some partly sunny conditions as we start our morning commute on Tuesday. But as soon as we get through Tuesday, going into Tuesday evening, here's that high pressure settling in over the Commonwealth. So very nice conditions for the start of this week. And in terms of the rainfall that we're expecting from this swath of showers that are now pushing through, again, not a huge dent, but it's a little bit of a dent into our drought conditions. We'll see about almost 4/10 of an inch fall in Harrisburg, but again, it's very beneficial for us. Now, to start off your Veterans Day, it'll be 66 degrees, breezy and milder for sure, partly sunny conditions, and then we'll cool down to the mid-50s by the time we get into Tuesday, breezy, and 56 degrees. We'll drop down to the lower 30s as well on Tuesday. As we get into Wednesday, we'll have some increasing clouds. And again, that next chance of showers on Thursday will be present for us in the middle of this week.